What's up? I'm Dave the Butcher. This is the Butcher's Bullshit. I'm going to start right out just by kind of talking about what's going on this weekend in Michigan MMA. Got two pretty big events that I know of for sure. There may be other ones, but they haven't been very well advertised, and I haven't seen anything about them, so sorry if there is other ones. In Greenville at the Clackles Pavilion, got Ground and Pound 35. And that's been advertised as quite a big card with some belts on the line. That's on Saturday night. Also, the IDC Fight League, Master Bay, which their first show was pretty big. My boy Phil the Voice, Davey, is announcing for them. That's at the Masonic Temple. They've got Up Top the Masonic. Eric Medill is fighting on that card, and Dom Sindone. There's a number of other people that are pretty big names downstate in the Detroit area fighting on that card. That's also going on Saturday night. So Detroit and Grand Rapids, it's got two pretty big shows going on. That brings me to what I did last weekend. I attended a show at the Palace by Donofrio Entertainment, the Impact Fight League. It was a great production. Once again, Phil the Voice Davey was announcing, killed it on the mic. Great fights. And one thing I noticed is a lot of people from fight leagues that I worked for in West and Northern Michigan went down there and took home belts. So I'm going to give some shout outs to those guys. Alana Jones got a tough victory. She fights out of Glenn Bailey's camp, which is American Muscle MMA. Chandra Engel also got a victory on a decision. Heck of a fight. Joel Vincent won a title down there, beat Pat Hook, tough opponent. Two good fighters right there, and he ended it in quick fashion with a standing guillotine. Zach Burns and Eric Medill, both from NWK out of Gaylord, who have a show coming up following weekend on November 5th, teaming up with Big John. Those guys both came out with great performances. Big props to them and Coach Larry Burns as well up there in Gaylord, going down there in Detroit and getting wins. Notable victory that I recall on the card also was Eric Ramirez fighting out of the Proving Grounds, Joe Battaglia's gym down there. Got a victory over a tough Joe Mr. Tricky Sleeves Rogers by submission. So that was what I did this weekend past. That was a heck of a lot of fun. I appreciate the invite to the show. I was treated very well by Mr. Donofrio and his staff, and big thanks to Phil for getting me in there. Speaking of NWK, November 5th at the Treetops Resort, Big John Eubanks is teaming up with NWK, and we've got a big show planned. Lots of good fighters. Still a couple spots left on that card if you want to get a hold of Big John. I'll be announcing that event, and I look forward to doing that. Always have a good time up in Gaylord, Treetops. Looking forward to that. Also coming up, November 12th, the MXC will be in Cedar Springs. I'll be on the microphone there. Joe Shaw in the UFL has a show in Davison. I know Big John's helping out with that show too. And King of the Cage will be in Sault Ste. Marie on the same night. Another big show coming up November 19th at the Palace again. And then I think November 5th is also going to be the Silver Dome, if I recall correctly. Not sure, but definitely check those big venues out. It's really cool to see MMA putting butts in the seats. You know, you see a lot of people at these big fights. Also coming up in the middle of November, the return of Bad News Ben Lagman to Michigan. He's going to be doing a series of seminars, probably available to referee events. Definitely get a hold of him. I know the 15th, it's going to be at the Grindhouse, which is the home of Great Lakes MMA, pro fighter Christos Piliafis, and there's going to be a seminar there November 15th, so make sure you check that out and get a hold of him if you're trying to book some events. And I know he's looking for November 11th. Trying to see if there's anything going on. So a lot of big stuff going on. Darren Cruikshank was signed by a rather large fight league in Canada after winning a title. Big props to that. Eric Moon's going to be fighting for Bellator coming up in November as well. So a lot of big stuff going on at the pro level in Michigan. Now, speaking of the pro level, I'm going to bring up a new segment here where, since we got the UFC coming up this weekend, I'm going to break it down. The first time I've tried doing something like this, and let's see what the response is. UFC 137, like I said, taking place this weekend in Las Vegas. Just start right out. We've got Hatsuo Hioki from Japan is fighting. He's a pride judo veteran. He's fighting George Roop, who I don't even know why he's on a damn UFC card. But anyway, I want to address the USA chant. You know, shout out to Bloodstained Lane on this. Sounds like the fucking World Cup when people do this. Respect these fighters. I hope Hioki comes out, finishes George Roop in grand fashion, and starts showing a little bit of pride in Shudo in UFC. We need some more of that. Chet Congo is going to be fighting this undefeated Matt the Meathead Mitrione, who I've hated ever since The Ultimate Fighter. One of the few seasons I've watched of that show. I mean, I try to watch when local Michigan fighters are on there. Looking forward to Miles Jury's debut in the UFC. But I hope Congo finishes Mitrione and gets back on track. That's my thoughts on that. Then we get to Roy Big Country Nelson. Now, he's an IFL vet. You know, a lot of people think he's kind of new because of the show and everything. But he went the distance with Mirin Dos Santos, and now he's going to fight Mirko Krokop. Krokop's one of my all-time favorite fighters. I mean, he's great. He's been awesome for the sport. Some of the best sound bites have come from him. Left leg hospital. I know he can head kick people into the rafters, but I got to go with Big Country on this one. I'm really rooting for him. I'm not really sure if I care who wins this fight because I like both of these fighters a lot, and I've read some things where they say Krokop's going to retire no matter what. So I mean, I don't necessarily want to see him get beat, but I love Big Country, so I'm really hoping that he does a good job here, and maybe he can get a finish. And we got the battle of two guys that are on win streaks here. We got Dennis Seaver against Cerrone. I really like Dennis Seaver lately. I like to see his kickboxers, and look like he can apply a little bit of judo to his technique. I don't know a lot about either one of these fighters, but I the last few times I've seen Seaver fight, I've enjoyed myself watching him, so I hope he wins this fight. Now here's one that I'd like to break down a little more. Tyson Griffin versus Bert Palazuski. Bert is a tough guy. He's won four of his last five, and then the last fight that he lost was a decision. He hasn't fought since December 2010. But Tyson Griffin is a person who's very underrated. He doesn't get a lot of credit, and I really think he should. I got to meet him in Detroit, and I really came away with a good opinion of the guy. He's a small guy, but he is really tough, good attitude, and he's coming off a streak-ending win versus Manny Gamburian. He lost three in a row before that. A couple of them, they're both decisions, so, they were weird ones. That was right during that little time where there's a lot of fucked-up decisions in the UFC. He's a real tough guy. His only losses are really to the champions and veterans like Takanori Gomi, Frank Edgar, Sean Shirk. I mean, and then the two losses out of the three that he lost there were decisions. So I really like to see Tyson Griffin get it together and get a win over this tough cat. Bert's no slouch either. And that brings me to the main event, and that's Nick Diaz versus BJ Penn. Now, I predict that this fight will be finished. It will not be a decision, and that Penn will go home the loser. And Diaz is the kind of guy that can finish you in a couple of ways. So I'm not going to say whether it's going to be a TKO, a knockout, or perhaps even a submission. But I do predict that he finishes Penn, and I believe that he's going to try to do it quickly because he wants to get that title shot back. And I hope he does. I like some of these abrasive personalities. They had a little dust up at the weigh-ins. That was some news for a minute. And he actually weighed in at 420. But that's what I got for this week. I don't have any shit to talk. There's been a few issues raised recently on, some of the message boards and Facebook walls that I've been following on the local scene. Nothing real major, nothing worth the coverage, really, except for there's some health issues that have been brought up. There was kind of a rumor going on about some hepatitis or something like that, and I believe even though it's not regulated, that blood work is a responsibility of all of us to encourage and try to make available, and it pretty much is as far as I know. If you want to get blood work done, you can. A lot of promotions require it. There's no regulation yet. There's groups that are forming, alliances that are forming, people that are trying to do the right thing, people that are doing other things too. So, my only advice on that is it's up to you as a fighter. Now, if you want to demand blood work before you fight, or don't fight for someone that doesn't produce blood work for your opponent, that's your decision. It's really ultimately up to your coach, your trainers, and whoever's in charge of your gym or your career. There's a lot of sponsorship available. There's a lot of health care based sponsor. Advanced Sports Labs comes to mind. They sponsor a lot of fighters on pro and amateur level. Your local health department can get you blood work pretty easily. It's cheap. Your sponsors should be able to help you with something like that at least. I mean, it's better than a pair of shorts, for sure. So, like I said, that's about all I got right now. Go out there and watch and support MMA. You know, have a good time. Help us keep going with this. You know, it's helps a lot of people's lives out in a lot of different ways. And it's keeping people employed in Michigan, and it's getting people out of Michigan as well on the professional tip. So on that note, I'm Dave the Butcher, and I'm out. I'm